Welcome to Lounge Academy. We'd like to welcome Liz Savino and Mike Duffy to the Blue Room this evening. Everybody's looking wonderful and perky. We all get perky when it's 45 degrees out. It goes went from 85 to 45 here in the big town, Buffalo. Hi, Liz. Wonderful to see you. Shirley's here. Robert and Susan. Nice to see y'all. All the lounge cadets are filing in for an evening of lounging and celebration of the Great American Songbook. On my right here, I've got Bob Davis, one of your favorite lounge cadets. Mary's toasting the evening, just out of the camera range. Mary says hi, everybody. Shirley Mayer is here, so the party can start. Judy Griggs is making the party really official. How you doing, Mike Duffy? It's great to see you, sir. Russ Renfoll is here to make sure everything, all the weights and measures are proper that we're dishing out every bit of the song that is promised, that we're not cheating on the weights and measures. Now, Liz, you're thinking of the Tuesday show on WBIG-TV. That's the donut show. This is the lounge piano show. It's actually the premise of the show is it's a live cocktail piano party where whether you're here or you're at home or on the space shuttle watching, wherever you might be, you can throw all your cares away and pick up a drink and your favorite pet and sit down and or keep us in the background and visit from time to time and enjoy the cocktail party, mixing with the other lounge cadets, making requests. It's great to see Oren here with his big heart eyes, looking good. So there aren't the short answer is, Liz, there's no donuts at this party, unless my guests find where I have them hidden, because we do share the set with Donut Tuesday TV show here at the Lounge Academy. Well, I'm going to put the microphone on the piano so that you can enjoy the improvisation, the jazz stylings of Robert Merlin Davis. Just an excellent world-class jazz pianist. So stick around and keep the comments coming in, and the cadets will be answering them, and we'll be answering your requests. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bob Davis,
your turn.
Warming up for you. You got another song in you, don't you?
I was supposed to mute a few minutes ago.
But I'm gonna, well, we know you're in demand.
Have a sip of something. Take off.
All right. Fair. Fair enough.
Better. She's working for a place
that was Bob Davis. Like we didn't know that. Well, that was fantastic. What a great set by Robert Merlin Davis, Bob Davis.
He works for a company that is going to make our window.
It's great to see. Great to see so many cadets in the audience tonight.
Is that how you got a company?
Fasten your seatbelts. We got off to an early start, and we hit the ground running with Bob Davis just taking off with finishing up his set with Over the Rainbow, Somewhere Over the Rainbow. This is the portion of the show where the lounge cadets are feeding, and you can see them all clumped over near the food at the end of the VIP table. They get quiet when they are feeding. Well, thank you, David. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for tuning in. It's always great to see you. Stick around. We're going to have who knows what. In fact, we never know who's going to walk in, which is why I'm going to go lock the door to make sure the public doesn't walk in here and get confused and think this is an open set. Yeah,
well.
Beautiful, cold night in Buffalo. Getting used to these temperatures. We actually have, I don't think any of the cameras. Oh, yeah. Kind of. There's some chairs blocking the fireplace. We actually got the fire going here at Lounge Academy. Seems about 40 degrees cooler than it was a few hours ago, it seems like. We're talking to Ray Emmerman.
Hey, Ray.
And David.
Hey, David.
Dave's Elector's son is in the audience. Dave, that's our David.
Sorry.
Yeah. No.
I think you're talking to yourself.
So where are you? I'm talking to two people. Where are you heading out to, Bob Davis?
I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep.
Well, I'm not surprised. That's why you brought your car.
I'm off to see Robert Frost. That's another story.
Robert Frost? Bob's gonna enjoy some of the buffet. Some lounge food. Nice to see Daryl in the audience tuning in from Florida. Bob Davis. Davis. How about another big round of applause for Bob Davis's last set? You see, when they're feeding me. When they're feeding, they're a tough audience. But they'll even set their food down for Bob Davis. Nice to see you, Vicky. Good evening. Paperwork involved in almost any endeavor nowadays.
You worry about that.
Even music. Look at all this paperwork. I don't even know where to start.
That's called sheet music, Howard.
Oh, well.
Sheet music.
Yeah, there's a lot of sheets.
But
you got to know your sheets around here.
Sounds like tape too.
Here's a song. Let's pull some out of the grab bag. Oh, that's. I don't need the music for that one. I know this one by heart, like we used to say when we were kids. We used to say a lot of things when we were kids. As far as I know, David, he's doing fine. I haven't spoken to him directly in a while. He owes me a phone call or two. I probably owe him a couple, too. But I speak with his handlers, and he's keeping everybody busy. Playing high-stakes bingo. Lounge sensation Guy Boleri taught me to start out with. He didn't know he was teaching me to start out with that. I was reviewing a Lounge Academy recording, a video from a few years ago. Guy Boleri quietly began his set here at Lounge Academy. Well, it was an evening that looked much like this, where the Lounge Cadets were in their feeding mode, were talking amongst themselves. Guy quietly began his set with this song. First time I ever heard the song. It's a song that asks a question. Well, thank you, David. I love the company of Elektra, that as did millions of people. She was everybody's favorite. I have a great memory of one time we had Thanksgiving dinner together, just Elektra and me and Jocko at the piano and all the patrons at the Hyatt. It was a rare year when Mary was out of town on assignment. So Elektra and I got together for Thanksgiving. And it was great. It was a great memory. She was so much fun. I mean, we spent a lot of time at that same cocktail table on many other nights, but that night was kind of special. Why shouldn't I take a chance when romance passes by? Why shouldn't I know of love? Why wait around when each age has a sage who has found that on this earth love is all that is really worth thinking of? It must be fun, lots of fun. Be sure when day is done that the hour is coming when you'll be kissed and then
you'll be kissed again. All debutantes say it's good. And every star out in far Hollywood seem to give it a try. So why shouldn't I? Just ask him.
Yeah, why shouldn't you? I take a push in the see next week.
Thank you, Bob Davis. Thanks for stopping by home base here at Mahoning Academy. One of the old members, good standing of Mahoning Academy, goes back decades. He was a young man. I've always been old. Bob Davis, ladies and gentlemen, is off to his next show business engagement. He's a busy man, because he's Bob Davis. He's not only a pianist, he's a magician. Like a real one. Like Bob Davis at Lounge Academy with you and me. Amy's in the audience tonight. She's got all her animals on her lap. They've all got cocktails. Vicky says goodnight, Bob Davis. There he goes. He is Mr. Show Business. He goes from one gig to the next. Good night, Dave Klager. Sir, thanks for saying hi. It makes my night. Watching us in split screen here at Lounge Academy. I'll show off what I can do here. Here's the overhead drone cam. It's a nice handy cam to use, like when one of the lounge cadets gets out of line, you know, we could cut them right out of the show. Until they pick themselves up. Tonight's Lounge Cadet audience, let me give a little color play-by-play here like they do on the sports shows. There's a shot of the VIP table, the end of the table. Now it's
private message.
Is everybody visible there? I think so.
Tony, my name is long rant on Mary Kate O'Connell's stirring endorsement of this company. Isn't that going to get a...
Now I'm on your right, talking animatedly right now, is Lounge Cadet Melinda Miller. Of Buffalo News fame. She spent more time in the police department than the commissioner. she'd sit there and get her stories. Sitting at the end of the table with his back to you, that extremely hip-looking lounge man there is. That's Mike Miller, it's Melinda's husband. I think you all know that, but in case you're new. Mike is also, not only is he an artist, an actor, he's a butcher. And a photographer, professionally, of course. I'm sure you've seen some of his work. To his left, to our left as well, is Lounge Cadet Lizzie, wearing the white fur. And to her left, of course, is president of WBIG-TV, Ryan Lysars. Well, it's hard to say, Vicki. You know, often at this time of the night, the crowd is about this size. Sometimes the whole night it is, but it's hard. It's very hard to predict. Now, I think Lounge Cadet Tina is in New York. Maybe she'll be tuning in remotely because she does that a lot. So I don't think she'll be here. She was Facebooking from New York City this afternoon, so she's probably not going to be here. She was with her nephew, who's in show business. Wu Dref, wonderful singer. We never know what's going to happen, Vicki. We ask the producers not to tell us so that we can act surprised. Over here we've got what we call the corner cam, because it's in the corner of the room there. Nice to see Brian in the audience, my designated drinker. Speaking of dozens, I'm glad you came in here and reminded me I set my wine down somewhere. Here it is. Thanks, Brian, for pointing this out to me. Here's to you, pal.
Well, if you're going to eat it quick, there's nothing wrong with it.
We've got, this is called the shoulder cam. Comes over my shoulder, and this will be good later in the evening when the lounge cadets are typically finished with their eating. They're attracted to the bright light over the piano, like moths. That all worked out. And then we've got the overhead. Then this is my favorite. We've got the split cam where you can see all the action at once, just like you're here whipping your head around watching as the celebrities walk around the room and conversations going. You can just look anywhere you want. Pick some songs out here.
What is the big huge chicken? We might be able to
have a special guest next week. I can hear over here a little bit of the discussion. I'm discussing a guest next week. Somebody who's a real chicken. Here's a song that should have been a big song and nobody knows it. Even the pros don't know this song. That's a nice song, Vicki. dig through the music for it a little later. Ryan Weiser, he's grabbing a little food from the buffet. Thank you, Michael. It is. It's a very, very nice night here. Off to a good start with musical guest and regular walk-on of Beer Lounge Academy. That's Bob Davis. If you were here earlier, or if you watched the rerun a little earlier in the telecast, a beautiful Bob Davis set. It's nice to see Justine here taking a break in between writing up orders for cars. Justine's been at Lounge Academy many times. Practically invented it. Well, we love all the angles too, Justine. Right, everybody? Was that your brother, Justine, that was chatting with me about the visualization stuff we were talking about, the sounds and colors? He gave a beautiful explanation to me. I appreciated that. I enjoyed what he wrote and found it very educational. Yeah, you're about due, I think, Justine. Oh, no kidding. Wow, great. What a great guy he is. Heart of mine. Song goes out to Justine. This heart of mine was doing very well. The world was fine as far as Justine could tell. Suddenly I met you and I dreamed at dawn I woke up singing sentimental overture. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. The world, I taste the wine of real romancing now. This crazy world has taken on a wonderful design. As long as life endures, it's yours, this heart of mine. Always a great audience, no matter which side of the camera you're on. Here at WBIG TV 25 in the big town of Buffalo. Regner and Ivor Square, we're telecasting from. That way we get a good signal out in every direction. We're broadcasting from this endangered historic building. The county wants to demolish it and put a convention center right on this spot. So we're fighting back with the great songs of the 20s, 30s, and 40s. Because they're an irresistible force. Especially with the lounge cadets. Interested in the piano. I think she's gonna come over and visit with all the home loungers. Here she comes, the glamorous co-host of Lounge Academy, Mary Kunz Goldman. Look how she holds her wine. She is. Getting a lot of thumbs up.
Are there a lot of lounge cadets watching?
There's a whole bunch of them. Justine's out there and Vicky.
Oh, Justine, come down here.
She says that, was pointing out how, well, you know, her son, Stu, who's a pianist at Solace.
There's parking.
Justine, Mary's beckoning you. She wants you to come down here.
It would be great to see Justine.
Somebody said, hiya, Mary. That was Vicky.
Hi, Vicky. And Gaia.
That's right.
Hi, Gaia.
Gaia, Vicky. Hiya, Gaia. Beautiful thing about Lounge Academy is
people can participate virtually.
You see, yeah, it's wonderful. It really is. It's
I love knowing people are watching.
It really is like having you here.
It is. Just knowing you're tuned in.
Yeah, it is, because they're part of it.
That's right.
You know, we're conversing, just like, you know, hanging out. She's going to beat her feet here next Friday for sure. Well, that's great. Way to go, Mary. It's Justine Jopp. She's the top. She's gonna be here next Friday for sure. So tune in. Justine Jopp on WBIG 25. Choice of 25. Don't make any plans. That's right, Vicky. It really is an amazing thing. Who would have thought? Couldn't have even made this stuff up a few years ago.
No.
That we, you know. Have you met Miss Jones? I've been meaning to ask Mary that.
Okay.
Someone said as we shook hands, she was just Miss Jones to me. Then I said, Miss Kunz, you're a girl who understands. I'm a man who must, I must be free.
Blah, 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 blah.
She showed me. All at once was scared to death. All at once I own the earth and I own the sky. Now I've met Miss Jones. And we'll keep on meeting till we die. Miss Jones and I. Miss Jones to me. Then I said, Miss Jones, you're a girl who understands. I'm a man who must, I must be free. And all at once I lost my breath. All at once was scared to death. All at once I own the earth and I own the sky. Now I've met Miss Jones and keep on meeting till we die. Miss Jones and I. Miss Jones and I. Make two. Spin on that one. Have you met Sir Jones? There's so many great songs, Mary Quinn's Goldman, and so little time. I'm going to dig through my paperwork here and pick out some really good ones.
Impressive paperwork.
Yeah, thanks.
And the
scantily, some of them are upside down. I got to organize this stuff. What's this one here?
No, because the red song comes to you.
This is a, well, at least so they're all like facing up and all the pages go in order, it would be. I don't know what book Because of You is in. Didn't we go through this once before, Vicki? Did we find it for you? What was the verdict last time on that? See, usually I've got a whole... by the time the requests start coming in, there's usually a whole piano full of paper handlers, clerks, court clerks. They can find the songs for me.
That's right, they're
here's one for Vicky. It's a beautiful song. I could hear her doing this. In fact, it would be really great if she did. This is Jimmy Van Heusen and Johnny Burke. Love is funny, or it's sad, or it's quiet, or it's mad. It's a good thing, or it's bad, but beautiful. Just grace.
Two for the road, Neptune. My cousin came from Rochester.
Thanks, Peter Joseph. It's great to see you here. Thanks for lounging with us, sir. I love that picture of your daughter over at delivering the donuts to Kevin. That's a classic shot. That's a keeper. Marino, you must remember this. A kiss is just a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as Marino goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. And that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Full of passion, jealousy, and hate. Woman needs man, man must have his mate. That no one can deny. There's still the same old story, fight for love and glory. Everyone's asking for you. One of the great songsmiths, Gary Marino. So what's new, Gary?
What's new?
I happen to know that one. Help me out with this one.
Well, has anybody seen Jekyll?
No. Well, Granville's been keep having dinner with him.
We called him. I talked to him when Ari was in town, and he didn't want us to come out. He said, we want to come see you. And he goes,
I get that feeling.
And he goes, no.
Yeah, he's too busy.
Oh, yeah, he was too busy. Yeah, that's what he said. We have like 3 days, when you're not busy. No.
So Silverstein didn't even get to see him? Well, that's saying something right there.
We don't care. We know it looks like shit.
Tell me you want to play bingo, high stakes bingo. WBIG TV President Ryan Lysaers, ladies and gentlemen. What an amazing group of show business titans up here. Yeah, you're seeing them in real time. Well, you're seeing him at about a 60-second delay. But he looks the same now as he did a minute ago or something. There's a lot of show business talk going around the room, as always. Artists, actors. I tried to get my phone working here so I could watch your comments in real time.
Just so we know
if it works. Here we go. We got Chili Billy out there in the audience, according to the computer. Peter Joseph, all-star cast. Of course, Vicky. A lot of these Disney songs are really great. Better than really great. What the hell? Bill Evans even used to record it. Alice. Alice in Wonderland. How do you get to Wonderland, Mary? Over the hill or under land, or just behind the tree. When clouds go rolling by, they go away and leave the sky. Where is the land beyond the eye that people cannot see? It's Richie, ladies and gentlemen. How great.
Somewhere.
I'd like to thank Ryan Weissart for making this all possible. Sellers here tonight. What a sight for sore eyes. Gaia says hello. She's watching on Facebook. Yeah. Yeah. She sent you hearts. She got all excited when she saw you walking in the room. Marino, too. Her whole crowd is here. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Gaia.
Can you hear Richie? She's saying, hi, Richard. Heart, heart, heart.
Wow. You are got all high tech.
Yeah. See what you missed?
You
missed all the upgrades. It's like ham radio.
I haven't been here in a long time.
It's been over a year, I think. What do you make out of all this, Mary Clinton's Goldman?
I'm enjoying it.
Bill Mister.
Guy waved back. Here's a Jimmy Van Heusen Sammy Kahn song from 1959. Kind of a new song. Right?
It was really rough. And the boat went like this.
Today, I may not have a thing at all.
It was like this.
Except for just a dream or two. Got lots of plans for tomorrow. I think I was singing in a different key. Today I may not have a thing at all, except for just a dream or two. I've got lots of plans for tomorrow. All my tomorrows belong. Now it may not seem like spring at all. We're drifting in the laughs. I've got rainbows planned for tomorrow, and all my tomorrows belong to you. No one knows better than I than what keeps passing me by. Soon be turning the tide. Just wait. Long legged arms that cling at all. To you that I'll be clinging to. All the dreams I dream, beg, and borrow. My tomorrow come true. All my bright tomorrows belong to you. All my mananas. I think Christina F. walked through the room.
Oh, no.
You're out there, Christina. Wonderful to see you here at Lounge Academy. And Jason's in the crowd. Welcome, Jason. Relax. Grab yourself your favorite cocktail, your favorite pet. Relax. We're having a great time at Lounge Academy tonight. Yeah, post what drink you're drinking. That's a good idea, Mary. Let us know what you're drinking. Here's to you. We're not encouraging. I mean, you could sit there and dry out if you need to. But this is a cocktail lounge TV show. So, at least have Kool-Aid or something. Justine's on the program. Well, I shouldn't say on the program. She's on the program. She wouldn't be holding a Manhattan for crying out loud. Let's hear it for Justine Jock and the Manhattan.
All right, Justine.
Here's back at you, Justine. And Gaia's got some Mike's Hard Lemonade.
Oh, there we go.
She's toasting us with.
Is Justine
there? Is Melinda Miller?
No, she's virtually. She's online.
Gary,
we got to toast each other.
That's my sad note. We have to go.
Did you notice the artwork I hung up in the orange room there?
Yeah,
this beautiful gift I received there. Okay. You got it. We're going to sit on one. Big lard. Big lard for the big guy.
Oh, our pleasure. It was just like, I don't have to do anything.
We're the butcher of hurdles.
Put the pressure on Molly.
For the butcher of North Buffalo. It's Mike Miller, ladies and gentlemen.
Nicely done here tonight.
Oh, thanks, Mike. Well, it's always well done when you're cooking the steaks.
We try. We always try.
We do too. What are you heading out to some more lounge destinations?
Yes. The school, the kids' swim team parents are having a get together, so we have to.
Nice.
Have to attend.
Is it a cocktail party?
Yes. Keep our heads above water.
Yeah.
We're going to try to do it.
Nice. That's great. Well, I heard they're quite a group.
They are.
The girls' swim team parents.
Yes.
That's how the Saturn Club started.
Swimmers?
Girls' swim team parents got together. Next thing you know, there was a goat painted green running around. It's true.
Sounds like something to do with dirt.
Might have. Huh? Well, counting on that, Mike.
Very good.
Mike Miller, ladies and gentlemen. And Brian Bond is in the crowd watching. Brian gave me my start in show business. He was on TV before I knew what it was. He's Brian Bond. Cheers, Justine. What are you kind of drink are you holding, Brian Bond? We're asking people what they're drinking. It's on my Facebook profile. Well, I just live streamed to my.
Just click right in?
Yes. Yeah. You'll see it on there if you look. Yeah. Well, I only have my password that's like the same for all my banks and everything. I got to set up a guest account. Thanks for reminding me. You can watch it in reruns.
Really?
Yeah, or if you leave and I don't leave, but I mean sometimes people leave and then all of a sudden they're on there like commenting on the other side of the camera.
Well, I can use my data on my phone to look at my Facebook.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I don't need an internet.
Oh, okay.
But I was also I've seen this on your Facebook, but it wasn't connected at that moment.
I see.
When you turn it off, it goes gives you a message. It's not connected.
So we
just broadcast live Friday nights?
Right. That's what we've been doing. Yeah.
How many people are in the audience?
Right now, there's a record number. There's four. I don't believe it, though. I think some people might be not counted because a couple of weeks ago or last week, at one point it said none. And I said, which happens, you know. And I said, is there really none, or can I believe this? Is there anybody out there? And a couple of people piped up. So I don't get it.
Unbelievable.
When somebody loves you, it's no good unless Rich Sellers loves you all the way. Happy to be near you when you need someone to cheer you all the way. He's got a channel, it's called Pete's Garage. He's got like 100,000 subscribers. You know, he actually makes like good money on it. And now Home Depot saw it and said they want him to demonstrate tools for the Home Depot videos on their website. They pay him, they send him all these tools. Yeah. He's a regular here. So it's not, it's like, you know, people say, do you know anybody who knows anybody that's, like, done well? And yeah, we do.
Is his name Pete?
Yeah. His name is Pete.
He just can't wear, his emblem was his name.
Oh, for the Home Depot stuff.
Wow.
He's very talented at it. He's got a good way of communicating. Margaret Phillips is watching. Hi, Margaret Phillips. We're asking people what kind of drink they're holding here at the Lounge Academy cocktail piano party. So how about it, Margaret? What do you got in your hand, drink-wise? Am I blue? Am I at Big Blue? Ain't these tears in these eyes telling you? Am I blue? You'd be too if each plan with your man done fell through. There was a time I was the only one. Till today, now she's gone and we're through. Am I at Big Blue? Jet Big Blue with the lounge cadets on Lounge Academy. Well, he's got some more coasters for the lounge cadets.
From Vermont.
I think we did this song. Thank you, Vicki, for the round of applause. She's a great audience. The great artists are the best audience. They understand the pain of the creative process. They're sympathetic. Here's for all the people that were waiting in line to get into Lounge Academy TV show tonight. Eyes above our blue. Facebook's trying to throw me up.
Throw
a loop here.
Michelle Trimper. You know Michelle.
Michelle. You went with her?
Yeah.
And
they have she owns they own Dead Pizza and Day.
Oh wow.
Good evening, Paul. Paul, nice to see you in the lounge, sir. Are you working tonight and lounging while you're working, or are you actually holding a drink tonight? Or all three? And we're asking tonight, what drink are you holding? We're asking all the home television audience if they're drinking. Yeah, that's a record, Vicki. Five watchers. Paul Cambry is in the audience, ladies and gentlemen. Keeping us out of trouble. I don't see any wrecking balls out there, so I guess he's doing a good job. He's doing work, very good. try not to distract you too much, Paul, because otherwise that client you're meeting in the morning is going to like not see light for a long time. Nice. I love cigars, Paul. I don't smoke them as often as I used to. I used to smoke them regularly. Often to kind of reward myself. You know, I think we all do that with our cigars. We rationalize why we're having one and we say we did something and worth commendating ourselves. But I don't smoke as many as I used to just because they started to. Actually, you know, when I started singing, I didn't have any choice. I had to cut back on the cigars because my sinuses were always impacted.
Oh, yes, I remember that with your sinuses.
Yeah. I even had an sinus operation once. You know, if I would have quit cigars, I probably wouldn't have needed that operation. I didn't even know it was any correlation. But I still smoke them on occasion. And they're fine. And I love it. I appreciate them that much more. Even Marino smoke. You still smoking those?
Backwoods.
The Backwoods on occasion?
Those
they're so good.
You're wrong, we were smoking the Muscatellos.
You got a harmonica on, man.
Let's get Richie a mic.
No, you know, not
trying to text.
I'm not going to broadcast this. I was just seeing
Richie,
I was in tune.
Please.
This is in tune.
Well, here's a mic.
Oh, yeah, get her over here.
Popolo.
You can do GF minor or something. G or
G.
Does she still live where she was living here?
Huh. E minor.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Can we play an F?
She lives in Kenmore?
You can do whatever you want.
I'm kind of blues challenged.
In North
Tonawanda?
Yeah,
Richie.
I don't have
a Main Street.
I don't have a green bullet, but
city.
You got an
SM
58.
Yeah, okay,
we
so
can
she
do this.
Moved. Yeah, I was.
I thought she moved.
No.
Yeah, no,
Main
she still lives there.
Main Street, Webster,
I'm glad she still lives there. That's a cool place for her. I wish she lived in Buffalo. But
come on over here, Richie, if you feel like it.
I love it there, man.
I love it too. She's right near the canal. I mean, it's a great place.
Oh my God, it's an unbelievable.
And she's got that bar Stamps right next door.
Stamps, Mooney.
That's all this jazz.
Fasten your seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen.
We got the Canal Club. These are all hangouts.
Richie Sellers. Because it's harp. It's a monster.
Doc's
amazing.
Remington.
We have a Doc's
Five. It's too bad Bob Davis isn't here to play some blues piano with him. I'll have to do it though.
We'll make the most of it. Every Monday night.
What do they do that?
Gino McManus and Frank Crisanti. They do the Beatles thing. Every Monday night I'm there. Beatles, burgers, and brews.
I've heard great things about that
Remington. Oh my
God,
Remington is unbelievable.
Hey Jack, how are you? Cheers, sir.
What? The band living in the condos right there. Living in the condos right there.
I'm glad you were tuned in, especially tonight. All your people are here, Gaia. Come on, Richie. Debussy. Play some blues in F. I'll just try to keep up a little bit.
Blues in F.
Can you do them at the same time?
No. And also, one more I've been practicing. It's the Bolero by Maurice Orville.
That's amazing, Richie.
Right, that's what I've been doing. I mean, it's just practice. At heart, I'm a blues junkie.
Well, I know that. Richie's got some blues albums out. Some CDs.
And I found somewhere I could play. I just went over to see that performance at the GFY.
Oh yeah, that's Guy's place, yeah.
Guy's place there?
No, his name is Guy.
Oh.
Richie's getting himself psyched up. We won't play. He's an artist. We'll let him blossom. Suzanne's out there. Hi, Suzanne. Nice to see you.
Hi, Suzanne.
Suzanne is watching, ladies and gentlemen.
I know. They're out there.
Yeah. Hopefully they'll be there when we open. I'm not in any hurry, Mary. Here's what Mary sang to me the first 20 years we were dating. Well, it was the first 4 or 5 years. I'm biding my time. Cause that's the kind of guy
I love that. I love that rhyme.
Other folks grow dizzy. I'm keeping busy. I'm biding my time. Something's bound to happen this year. This year, I'll just keep on napping. I'm biding my time. Cause that's the kind of guy.
Bide
my time.
It's one of my favorites. It's really up top. It's not that much slow, but I'm too much. It's great that you have that.
I've seen it twice while I had to do
it. Oh, it's just a beautiful thing. Thank you for offering it to me. I really don't read
music. I don't know what English letters. Because I really don't read music.
It's so great you had that. Thank you.
Something's bound to happen this year, this year. I'll just keep on napping. I'm biding my time. That's the kind of guy I'm. No regretting when I'm sudden. I'm biding my time.
Try something in F.
We're just taking like some Molotov sonata. And I always do that with my pass.
Hello to the
fire department is here. I don't think they're coming here. What kind of groove are you in tonight?
You can do this one. That
was it? All right. Go ahead, Steph. Can you get closer to the mic? You'll hear yourself. Right there. Yeah, but nothing can hear you. They can't hear you.
Can you hear me out there?
Well, I don't hear anything coming out of here.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
You either get closer. Or, yeah.
We'll slow it down.
Okay.
For Friday night.
Okay. Piano's good. It's in tune.
A lot thickened.
A lot thickened.
It's Myron.
I couldn't help it. I saw you in the
This is amazing. It's Myron Robbins, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, I haven't seen you in the dog's age.
How are you, sir?
Hey, buddy. How you doing?
Hello.
Hi, Richard.
Nice to see you.
You're looking even
better.
He looks great, doesn't he? I'm Howard.
Jai.
Jai.
Hi, I'm Richard.
This is Richard.
Hi, Richard.
Good evening. Good evening.
I'm Jai.
Jai, I'm Howard.
Is this just like old times or what?
It is. It's great. Think a great night. Richard hasn't been here in years. You guys must have planned this. We're live streaming on my Facebook.
Is there an attendant for the parking lot? Is this the office that paid for my parking?
Don't park illegally there. They'll bite you.
There's a dog.
Oh, look at this.
There's a dog.
No dogs right now. Well, dog.
Okay, Richie.
Remember
you
from way back?
Yeah,
Gary was about to
leave. Start the song, and I'll start out. Who's in? Start out, and I'll try to keep up with you.
That was really fun. That dinner at your house was epic. That night we did for the club.
I screwed a few things up.
No, it's fine. Remember your painting of Judith?
Yes,
yes.
Remember Judith?
Yes.
That's the Myron Robbins Blues, ladies and gentlemen.
Christine up there? Is she watching tonight, Ari?
No, Ari's...
You look the same.
Ari's had probably some big.
It was really how much fun we had when we all went and saw Borat.
Yeah, thanks, Bob. Yeah, we got when you got Rich Sellers in the house, he plays some blues. That's for sure.
Jazz?
Okay. Myron, you got any cause for Moss in Forever?
I've been guilty on that.
Well, me too. He hasn't been calling me, and I'm.
Well, maybe they locked him away from the phone. That could be. He sneaks in and he uses the house phone.
I called a couple weeks ago. I called up and asked for him, and she said, "Oh, he's probably on his way to breakfast now. So call back later." And then I didn't call back, but at least they knew who he was and he was there.
You know what his birthday is?
I forget. I always counted on him to remember all the birthdays.
Let's get a couple people go down and wish me happy birthday.
That'd be here, let's try this one. Here's one in F. It's not a blues. It's called The Blue Room. Rodgers and Hart. Richie, you want to just pick up on this? And we'll... Here, I'll play it through once.
Go ahead.
And then we'll do some harp. We'll have a blue room, new room for two rooms. Every day's a holiday, 'cause you're married to me. She knows who's allowed in and who's the public. Mary, get the door.
Yeah.
I think it's Barry, but I'm not sure. Hope it's Barry. All right. It's Barry. She's a wonderful guest. Party's just starting now. Moses says hi. Got some requests. This request goes out to Paul Cambria. This is what he tells his clients when things don't go the right way. He says, "Don't worry, time goes by. You'll be out in no time." Come on, Kathy. Barry just showed up. Why don't you guys get down here? Here's one for Paul Cambria. Stay in age we're living in. Pause for apprehension. Speed and new invention. Things like third dimension. Did we grow a trifle weary? Mr. Einstein's theory. We must get down to earth at times. Relax, relieve the tension. Better with the progress. But we all prove the simple facts of life are such they cannot be removed. You must remember this. Kiss is still a kiss. Sigh is still a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs, never out of date, heart full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate, that no man can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by. As time goes by. What a great request by Paul. The song he sings to his clients. So, since don't worry, 10 years will go by. Right, Paul? Thank you for the great request. What do you got there?
Major, minor roles. Oh. Minor related to relative majors. So I can find out a key and play with it.
So, wow. I don't even understand it.
Sessions is the name of the song.
Is it an earthquake? Or simply a shock? This goes out to Kathy Moses. Is it the good turtle soup? Or merely the muck? Is it the cocktail? This feeling of joy? Or what I feel, the real McCoy? simple you are. Granada, I see your ole as Barry Park. Is it the fancy not worth thinking of? Is it a long, long last love? Time, or simply a lark. Is it Granada I see only as Barry Park? Is it the fancy not worth thinking of? Or is it a long, long last love? Long last love. That's a Cole Porter tune. He writes so many great songs. We got the big music lovers in the audience tonight. A great group of people. You're on Lounge Academy. Get this one. That's another. It's nice to see Frank de Cesare in the audience. The broadcasting engineer of WBIG TV. Here's one in E flat. They're writing songs of love, but not for me. Oh, lucky stars above, but not for me. With love to lead the way, I found more clouds of gray than any Russian play could guarantee. I was a fool to fall and get that way. I owe less it all and lacks a day. And though I can't dismiss the memory of her kiss, I guess she's not for me. I was a fool to fall and get this way. I owe less and all, so lackaday. Although I can't dismiss the memory of her kiss, I guess she's not. She's not for me. I guess she's not for me. nice. Nice rich cellars. It's like an orchestra. Great to see you out there, Bernie. They say I'll move a mountain. Excellent, Richie.
Good.
I can tell you've been doing good just by looking at you. How you doing, Barry? Nice to see you, sir.
Nice to see you.
Good. Were you watching TV and then you decided to come down?
No, we were out to dinner. At the Rust Belt.
At the Rust Belt. Sounds like a great place.
You ever been there? It's across from
the... I haven't.
It's been across from the Ford plant there.
Oh, great.
Used to be like an Italian restaurant, and Reagan went there when he was president.
Oh, no kidding.
They came to Buffalo. And,
it wasn't the Rust Belt then. It was a different,
no, was a different
Italian restaurant.
Yeah, and, the plant was still operating.
Those were the days when the plant was operating.
That was it. I worked there myself.
You worked there?
Yeah. It's a boiler
department. Oh, really?
Boiler washer.
What, as a kid? Like
yeah,
a school
yeah.
job?
Yeah, 20 years old.
Yeah, that's great.
Why did you do it?
There's a song that's... that goes out to Myron Robbins. Sings it every time he gets off the phone with Moss. They say I'll move a mountain. And I'll move the mountains if she wants them out of the way. Crazy, she calls me. Sure, I'm crazy. Crazy in love, I'd say. Say I'll go through fire, and I'll go through fire if she wants it, so shall it be. Crazy, she calls me. Crazy in love, you see. Like the wind that shakes the bough, she moves me with her smile. The difficult I'll do right now, the impossible will take a little while. They say I care forever, and I mean forever. forever. If I have to hold up the sky, crazy she calls me, sure I'm crazy, crazy enough am I. They want to put a convention center here?
Yeah, so look at the characters on TV.
Oh, they're not going to do that. What do you make? Got any advice for me on that?
I'm here to have a Stantler and build a state-of-the-art convention center on the circle.
Good idea.
This is a very nice spot.
Do you think I should complete my local landmark?
They should leave this, they should
leave. I should do it? Go ahead and do it.
I need to know a little more.
Oh, okay.
Say yes or no. You know, if it achieves your goals, and I think your goals are not selfish goals. If it achieves your goals, do it. If it's not going to achieve them, I don't know what to do. I used to own the Fisherman's Wharf.
I remember, yeah. Yeah, I remember you told me the story about that. We had some contract problems with it. That's where Soho is over there now?
Why did you bring me?
it's become a Friday night habit for us. I still got it. I'm trying to get a, trying to find some roofers that I like to put a roof on it. Yeah, roofs are AVA. I'll write it down because. Rocco,
how you for session? Russian. Go to the studio. What do you think? Are you ready?
Hold on.
I'll pay for the time.
For what?
Studio session.
Studio session?
Yeah.
No, you accompany the sound. 602-3947.
All right. What? How do you spell his name? Okay. I'd like to teach people how to improvise, you know. People that play that would like to get away from the sheet, you know, and be able to play. Because I developed my own teaching method for it, and I'm the only one I've taught with it. But I found out it works, you know. So.
It's true, because you don't really have to be skipping notes. You should listen
right.
to... I have a friend. I just tell her, can you play this one? Give me the first, just the first, you know. And then she can just get along with it. You know, Bobby, when we have a jam session here...
I do at the Statler, yeah.
Anywhere else?
Not very. No, I'm not restricted. Yeah, I do the, you know, the receptions, you know, when everyone's drinking cocktails and they walk in, I play them in as they walk in, the people, and then they do their cocktail hour. It's usually an hour. So I start like 15 minutes before it to walk them in. And then finish 15 minutes before they're done. Because by then, they're full volume anyway. And they want them to get into the next room for dinner, you know. So they want me to stop so they could hurt them. Yeah, it's fun. It's fun. I like doing that. You noodle around. You can play all kinds of...
Yeah, it's like... It's like it starts to read notes.
Oh, yeah.
I am more like... I don't want the traditional one. Like you said, like just visit it and then
I like being able to play even if you're not playing a song. Like now I'm not playing anything.
Yeah.
You should just have a sound.
Yeah.
You know. And then if you happen to be playing a song, then you do the same things but you pour it into the song. I find it's actually easier if I'm not playing a song. It's one less thing to think about is the progression. I don't have... Oh. We do that all the time over here. He dances overhead on my ceiling near my bed in my sight through the night. I try to hide in vain underneath
the counterpane, there's my love. I whisper, go away, my lover. It's not fair, but I'm too grateful to discover.
It's kind of weird, but I like it.
She's still there. I love my ceiling more, since it is a dancing floor, just for. My love. Too late, Paul, but we're not going anywhere yet. We're only a few steps away from you. Right on the other side of Niagara Square. It's Paul Cambria. He's trying to keep somebody out of jail. Funny, and he requested as time goes by. I said, is that what you sing to the guys when it doesn't work out so well?
Well,
don't worry, time goes by.
5 to 20. Yeah,
yeah, it'll go by.
Speaking of that, when I play that tune at the retirement community, they go nuts over. They love
it. Oh, well, sure.
Well, yeah, because they all have a love or something like that. And they also
they lose things all the time.
Smoke gets in your eyes.
Oh, that's a beautiful melody. The smoke gets in your eyes. It's an incredible melody. The melody is so good.
Here's one.
Well, Jerome Kern wrote it.
Henry Mancini and Johnny Mercer.
Who did it? Maybe Hogie Carroll.
I love it too. It's a beautiful melody.
Days of wine and roses, laugh and run away, like a child at play, through the meadow and toward a closing door. Paul's on his way, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Cambria is on his way down. Yeah, his office is just all, he happened to be watching on TV. He'll be glad to see you out. The days of wine and roses, laugh and run away, like a child at play, through the meadow and toward a closing door, a door marked nevermore.
just a passing breeze, filled with memories of a golden smile that introduced me to the days of wine and roses and you.
What a great night this turned into. It started out as one, too. Mercer and Henry Mancini. No wonder it's a great song. A couple of ringers. How many units you up to? How many units is he up to? How many units is Myron up to? Did he break 1,000? You once told me your goal. Well, you're not done. Or did you hit a good number? You're better off. I've already got two of them. I've got two already like that. Yeah. Yeah, now that I figured out how to lose money on two, I could probably figure out how to lose money on 100.
When I'm married, I shortened my life. Instead, I'm enjoying
it. I don't blame him. He worked really hard. I'm glad he's able to, you know. Yeah. No, he's. What's the point? No, I mean, there's. I agree. Oh, good. Kathy and Nick are on the way.
Oh, I was wondering.
You be so easy to love, easy to idolize others above. So worthy the yearning for, so swell to keep all the home fires burning for. So grand at the game, carefree together, does seem a shame. You can see future with me, cause you were your soul, easy to love. So I'm going to open this place before they crush it, Myron. I'm going to open this place before they crush it. I already started the liquor license.
work. I gotta hit everything on my bucket list real quick before the bucket comes. Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, you irreplaceable you. Just one look at you, my heart grows tipsy in me. You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me. I love all the many charms about you. Above all, I want my arms about you. Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa, do. My sweet embraceable you.
That's an old chestnut.
I love all the many charms about you. Above all, I want my arms about you. Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa, do. My sweet embrace about you. It's nice to see David in the audience. Great having a room full of people that love the old songs. People that are actors and artists of all types. Apartment artists. Bullshit artists. Because artists understand the pain of the creative process. That's why they make such a good... on his way over, Mary. Cambria.
He's on his way over tonight.
Yeah. He's leaving his client's paperwork. This guy's just going to have to fend for himself
over?
In court tomorrow morning.
He's not coming over tonight.
Yeah, he said he's on his way over. I don't know. Is there court? Yeah, there's probably no scheduled court. Arraignments, right? If they bust you, yeah, traffic court. I don't know if he's too involved in that. He's a busy guy. A foggy day. This is Paul Cambria walking through the fog all the way across Niagara Square. A foggy day in Buffalo Town had me low. And had me down. I viewed the morning with alarm. The British Museum had lost its charm. How long, I wonder, can this thing last. The age of miracles had come and passed. Suddenly I saw you there. Foggy London town, the sun was shining everywhere. In London town, in Buffalo town. It's in one of the books. I need the music for it though. That's a great song. Great song. I think it's in G. Usually in
I see a song called Green. It's their only one called by Benny Green.
I think it's also B flat.
Green.
You know, all those.
I got it.
Is this live on Facebook? Yeah.
No, it's not in this book. We've got all these old books I buy before right now.
I got some new.
I have a huge library at home, so I'll be buying stuff out of them for every sale.
Here's one from Myron. Likes to keep things in perspective.
Yeah, look at these. I want to hear all the songs.
I don't believe in fretting or grieving.
Oh, yeah.
Why mess around with life? I was never cut out to step out or strut out. Give me the simple life. Some find it pleasant dining on pheasants. Those things just roll off my knife. Give me tomatoes and mashed potatoes. Give Myron the simple a cottage in Canada that's small is all he's after. One that's spacious, and then he did a whole bunch of work too. A house that rings with joy and tenants. Or the one you love inside. Some like the high road. I like the low road. Free from the care and strife. It sounds corny, seedy, and yes indeedy. Give me the simple life. Only 900. Thank you. I have to thank the ladies at the VIP table. She was too good to me. How can I get along now? So close she stood to me. Everything seems all wrong now. I would have heard the sound of me making me smile. That was her fun. She'd never say, go away now. I was a king to her. Who's gonna make me gay now? It only natural. I'm blue. She was too good to be true. Richards, Rodgers and Harris. Yeah. Another great one by Rodgers and Harris. Here's one Gary Marino taught me. Hey there. You with this? You gonna help me out with this, Marino? You used to be so wild. Hey there. You on that high flying cloud. Though you won't throw crumbs to you, think someday she'll come to you. Better forget her. With her nose in the air, she has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Would you take this advice I hand you like a brother? Or are you not seeing things too clear? Much too in love to hear. All going in one ear. Nice song. Marino turned me on, to use the drug parlance of the 60s. He turned me on to a lot of songs. That was one of them, from the Pajama Game. There's always a hipness to the Marino songs.
That song was on the dictaphone.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
The Pajama Game. It was on the dictaphone. The guy was sitting at his desk. And he came over the dictaphone.
I think Paul got arrested on the way over.
Anybody tuning in there?
Yeah, it's hard to tell because the initial control page blew up.
Sometimes.
So it doesn't tell me as much information, but.
Found the picture, but not the audio.
Oops. Really?
Yeah. Or it stopped. Period.
Yeah, we got at least three people tuned in. There could be some that are being modest. Worldwide. Which isn't bad. Three's pretty good.
Yes, yeah, you see in our blues or something, you can get aware of the chord changes, which I was not. And as a classical pianist, that helps you. That's what most animals
want to know. There's a nice song.
Beautiful harmony, and I can put this into this song.
Your eyes don't shine.
No, I guess they tried, but I don't think.
Like they used to shine. And the thrill is gone. When your lips touch mine, I'm afraid the masquerade is over. So it was love. And so is love. Your words don't
know. And I still love that.
what they used to mean. They were once inspired. Now they're just routine. I'm afraid the masquerade is over. And so is love. And so is love. I guess I'll have to play Pagliacci and get myself a clown's disguise. I'm afraid the masquerade is over. And so is love. And so is love. Masquerade is over, but the night is not. Mary, see if Paul's at the door. Mary, see if Paul's at the door. He's the guy at the door. Maybe he wants our address. He thinks we're at the stabber. I can't answer much. Maybe I can send you a message. Alright, we got a hold of him. He's outside.
You made it through it.
Myron, let Paul in, would you? You're watching Lounge Academy on WBIG-TV. Myron didn't lock himself out. He knows something about buildings. He says he's outside coming in. So where is he?
Maybe he's a savant, you know, like he's brilliant at like all these things. Maybe he's trying to get in the booth. His clients. You know, he's got a whole list of them. It's Paul Cambria. Where is he? He said he's coming in.
Hey, Alfred. What's going on?
He has to go and see a client.
Is he breaking in?
No. Is he out there? Is he driving a pickup truck? I doubt it.
I doubt it too.
Well, somebody's going crossing the street towards here. I think that's them.
Here
he is.
There he is.
I recognize the wall.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I recognize the wall.
The Esquire's coming?
He is.
You're the lawyer.
I might. Not at that point.
Yeah, when you need him, you got some problems. Let's hang back. It's got Paul coming in and stuff.
He's going to steal the show, in other words.
Yeah. I'd like to welcome Paul to the Blue Room tonight. Is that Razor?
That's Razor.
It's Razor. This is amazing. Razor's here. Welcome. Make yourselves at home. It's Paul and Razor's first time to Lounge Academy. It's about time. Now you know where to come to get a donut.
Now I
know
for sure.
I hate to say anything, but I think Paul's parked illegally out there. It's parked over where the feds
are.
You're over there too?
Yeah.
You guys must know somebody. The night's just getting rolling. Nick and Kathy are on the way over too. This heart of mine was doing very well. The world was fine, as far as I could tell. Suddenly I met you, and I dreamed of gay amour. Dawn I woke up singing, sentimental overjoyed. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. Say hi to Paul. Hey, my Paul. I'm talking to Myron. Song then asks the question, have you met Miss Jones?
Mr. Jones.
Have you met Miss Jones? Someone said as we shook hands, she was just Miss Jones to me. Then I said, Miss Jones, you're a girl who understands.
I'm a man who must be free. And all at once I lost my breath. All at once was scared to death. All at once I owned the earth and I owned the sky. Now I've met Miss Joan, and I'll keep on till we die. Miss Jones and I. How come when I play, everybody's talking, and then Paul walks in, and Razor, and the whole place, people stop talking. These guys, they suck the talking right out of the room. They think they're in court. It's been a long time. You guys bring any racing cars with you tonight?
No, we should have brought booze.
You brought booze?
Yeah,
I guess. Oh, well. Within reason, we don't want people getting too bombed. I don't know. It's good for business, I guess. We've got some wine and some beer. There's stuff around here for you. Help yourself. You know where everything is. And watching Lounge Academy, you know where everything is. Famous. I can't believe we're meeting him. No. Sit around, everybody. We got a lot of talent in the room, a lot of big acts coming up.
Is it waiting for the smoke gets in?
If you could find it for me. It's in one of my really old books. It might be in this one.
Oh,
yeah, that goes into that B,
into that
the bridge in
key.
B or something.
Yeah, I know, it's really easy until
I remember
into
that.
The bridge. Yeah, and then all of a sudden it turns into a nightmare.
Here's one for all the writers in the audience. We have a lot of authors.
We will get someone to do this sooner or later tonight. Someone will do Smoke Gets in Your Eyes.
If they ask me, I could write a book about the way you walk and whisper and look. Found it? I can write the preface on how we met, that the world would never forget, and the simple secrets is just to tell them that I love you a lot. Then the world discovers, as my book ends, how to make lovers a friend. I never wrote a book. Not yet, anyway. Oh, thank you. Now I can write a book. See if we can plow through this one. I remember It has like a minefield in the middle. It starts out really nice. Smoke It's in Your Eyes, a beautiful song. And then it goes. I always loved this song though. She's never played it in it. Glad she recommended it. I think. Attendants, flight engineers will find the charts for that one so we can navigate through it safely. We do things by the book around here, literally. See. What a melody. What did Hoagy Carmichael write it or something? Because it's got. What year? What? 1935 sounds like. Thank you. Let's build a stairway to the stars and climb a stairway to the stars with love beside us. Fill the night with a song. We'll hear the sound of violins out yonder where the can't we sail away on a lazy daisy paddle over the rim of the hill? Can't we sail away on a little dream instead of high on the crest of a thrill? Stairway to the stars. It would be heaven to climb to heaven with you. What a song. It's so melodic. We gotta put that one in the rotation.
Go two more pages forward.
Stardust. 438. No, this is where 320.
Oh, three. Maybe it's three. Two pages.
Yeah. Where'd it go? It's got to be here somewhere. I think that one might be.
That was third of the stars. Stardust was supposed to be right next to it.
That's a tough one.
Oh, yeah, no, I tried playing it. It doesn't work for you. Is that right there? Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, I'd have to work that one out.
Okay.
That one is.
It's got a lot of it.
It's one of the most beautiful songs ever written.
Yeah. How about Moonlight from Mars? You play that?
Yeah, I think I got that in one of my old books. You're pulling out some stuff from years ago.
It's been a while. We'll be back real soon. Is it next Friday?
Please, yes.
Okay. I'll see you Friday.
I'll be counting on it.
This was, we were just driving down Delaware Avenue. And that's what we saw the lights on. I U-turned and found a spot.
Myron, leave me a message on my phone so I've got your current number. I still got my old number.
In my email.
So you can just show me around.
Yeah.
Current number.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. It's nice meeting you.
I'm gonna see you again.
Bring him back soon.
I will.
Yeah.
I'm glad to stop. I'm really glad.
Well, you're me too. It's, you're a great audience. You know, you really love your music.
I love music. Music doesn't like me, so.
Oh, well, we can.
It's one of those things.
Well, you know, that's how I was.
So I tried to learn how to sing. I can sing. I can sing.
Oh, you can sing.
You can sing.
I
can't sing.
Oh.
So maybe I got
better. You know, I was the same way not that long ago. You know, so it's.
At least you get.
No, but I couldn't at all. I mean, I couldn't.
Heck of a transformation.
Well, thanks. Well, it's a work in process. I'm not kidding. There's a method to it. No, I didn't. No.
You've done a heck of a job.
Oh, well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Where did you take lessons from? She said you
taught yourself. I did take voice to learn how to support it.
Yes.
And I actually had two good mentors. One for one for style, you know, one for the act, and one for the technique, the support. So I was lucky. I happened to have like a couple of great guys take an interest in it. Well, thanks. Well, that's, I enjoy that. So, Paul, what are you working on? No wonder you're working late. Wow. I once had a domain dispute. It wasn't a criminal. I had a website. I had a business called 00711 in the mid 90s. It was my first website, and it was successful. It was a spy store. Now, I didn't have any local spy stores. I just had a website, and it became a very successful mail order business. But mail order was always my background anyway. I just never had a website because they hadn't been invented yet. I used to use printing presses, you know. And come on, sit at the piano, Paul. Come on up to the piano, hang out.
These fellas own the Village Voice newspaper, and when Craigslist came in, they took all the advertising. So they then started their own thing called Backpage and took all the advertising.
Okay.
And a lot of people advertised on, including a bunch of hookers. And so now the feds came in and said, well, you're promoting prostitution. They said, no, we're just an advertiser.
Right.
Communications Decency Act is a whole bunch of different things. So this is an experimental prosecution.
I see.
Directed by Washington. Directly by Washington. And they've scooped these guys up. And the guy that I have is one of the original founders of Village Voice. And they literally took $700 million of his money.
They seized
it, and we're fighting it. So it's in Phoenix and Sacramento. We're in two places. And Los Angeles, three places.
Although those seizures make me uncomfortable, you know.
Well,
I mean, in America, you know.
This is in a First Amendment area.
I mean, you're not convicted yet.
No, I'm going to take.
And I paid for this place with federal forfeitures. The business I was in, I was selling them the gear to catch these guys, and they could only use the federal forfeiture funds to buy more gear or use training. So. But I didn't like the idea of it, you know. I mean, I did my job and got paid.
But see,
but I don't think, you know,
these guys are publishers. They're like,
you should be convicted before.
Analogous to a library, they're going, we're not responsible for everything in the books.
Right.
You know, there are 5 million ads that we're sponsoring every day. And anyway, it's an experimental prosecution. But we're in it. There's like 19 lawyers.
Wow.
And but I have the founder.
You know what else? What else is left to advertise? You got to take the stuff that like the big monopoly leaders can't do. You know.
But our position is who's the advertiser,
right?
If people who are advertising are committing crime, prosecute them.
Yeah, they're not making any representation.
We're just a platform. That's it. So it's interesting. We got lawyers from everywhere, and the lawyers for ABC and CBS TV are the ones who brought me.
Oh, it's really, it sounds like a big case.
$9 million. We got up for the arraignment. We got up for the arraignment. The judge said to the government, how many documents are involved in this case? $9 million. the trial is 2020, and we may have to move it to 2021.
So are these guys crippled, out of business in the meantime?
Absolutely, out of business.
Now,
they went from mega, rich people to they can't pay their property taxes because the money's crazy.
Now,
so we filed,
when they're eventually, off the hook on this, assuming you know, it goes their way, do they have any recourse of these losses?
No, just get their money back. They get their money back, and in the meantime, spend probably $18 million on legal fees. There's $19 million.
And lose their business.
Oh, the government took the business. So if they win, they get it back and open it up. It was doing $50 million a month.
$50 million a month. Must have been illegal during the $50 million a month. Guilty.
Yeah.
Right? You're there, they're like smarter than, Trump and everybody else. $50 million a month.
And basically, they took the village for
it,
put it out of business, and went in totally to the web advertising. Crazy. What's that song you want to hear?
Barry, let's try to get Barry to play a couple of songs. Barry, do you mind playing a little bit?
Sure.
Give it a little tweak tune-up this week.
Sound nice.
Thanks. It helped a lot. There were just a few. Just like two or three strings that were just loud. Makes all things sound out of tune.
It's nice and bright.
Yeah.
Take it, take it, take it.
Not more to it. Old lovers.
Thank you. Thank you.
from Les Mis.
That's